This bye week is much needed for the Eagles players' health. But I don't know about y'all, but the bye week can drag. We got a lot going on in this channel for this bye week to keep things moving, because after the bye, we got a game that is the biggest game of the year. So today I want to talk about the Eagles offense in its totality. Some people say you can't run yourself to the playoffs. Bill Belichick says otherwise. And last but not least, we got some Pro Bowl players on this team. Get your votes in.
This is Philly Talk with Philly Mike. Talking sixes in the bird game, that's our life. Competition, we ain't scared, yeah, that's what we like. Win or lose, you know we showing up and we gon' fight. You see we strive for the sky every day that go by. And every single week we screaming fly, Eagles fly. This is Philly Talk with Philly Mike, yeah. This is Philly Talk with Philly Mike, yeah.
What is going on, everybody? I go by Philly Mike, and this is the Philly Talk Podcast, and today we got some things to talk about. But before we do that, Eagle Nation, help your boy out and hit that like button. Subscribe if you are new, and ding that notification bell so you know when these videos drop. Let me hear from the great 6'2".
Keep that roots going, baby! Roots on three!
One, two, three, roots!
Hey, once again, I'm glad Kelce, Taron Jackson, Steven Nelson all look to be a go after the bye week. And even guys like Jordan Howard, Brandon Brooks is going to get reassessed. So this is a much needed bye week, although it takes forever to get there. And I want to talk about this Eagles run game, its pass game, its points per game, and its total offense. And just the fact that people believe you can't win with a running team. It can be done. But you have to sprinkle in some good, efficient passes. And that's where I think Jalen Hurts needs that work in the pocket. But I saw some flashes in the Chargers, the Broncos, the Lions, the Saints game before it went crashing down against the Giants. But one game ain't going to make or break anybody in this league, especially when they only have a handful of starts. But let's get into the Pro Bowls. Let me know in the comment section if you believe the Eagles have some Pro Bowlers, whether it's offense, defense, talking about the Lane Johnsons, the Jason Kelces, the defensive players, because there's one person I got to talk about right now, and that is the one, the only, Darius Slay, who's been locking people up low-key. PFF put this out, Darius Slay in single coverage, and I think JG got to put this man in single coverage more often, but put him against the number one, let him shadow. 89.1% PFF grade, which is first. 4 catches allowed, 2 interceptions, and a 2.8 passer rating allowed. First place. Now, he don't play single coverage man all the time, but he has some fumble recoveries to the house. He got touchdown after touchdown after touchdown on the defensive side, and he locks up in man coverage. This guy's getting older, but he's not done. And some Eagle fans say we only can have him for maybe one more year or two. Let's see what this guy can do. You know, Malcolm Jenkins played a different position, but he played into his, he's still playing. So I'm not saying we can stretch Darius Slade out to that. But let's worry about getting a nice CB2 so Steven Nelson can go bye-bye. You did your share. You're better than Michael Jacquet. That's why we got you. But let me know, Avante Maddox. Not necessarily on the outside, but what he's doing in the slot. Lane Johnson, Jason Kelce. I think we can get some Pro Bowlers, right? Fletcher Cox is known commodity, but he's not having a good year. I don't think you could put anybody on a D-line in the Pro Bowl. But let me know who you would select from the Eagles on the Pro Bowl. Maddox can get a shot. Slay, definitely. And let's not forget Jake the Great, 91%. 91% from field goals. Put him in the Pro Bowl. Put him in the Pro Bowl. Now, let's talk about this. You can't win games against good teams if you run. Bill Belichick's like, hold my beer. Y'all saw last night's game. Yes, the weather conditions played into it, but Josh Allen threw the ball 30 times. 30 times Josh Allen threw the ball. What did Mac Jones do, right? This is the so-called best rookie of this class. Not necessarily projecting long-term, but Trevor Lawrence in Jacksonville having his struggles. Zach Wilson having his struggles. Trey Lance can't get on the field. The dude for the Bears, Mac Jones is doing the best. And he has some good games where he won with his arm. But Bill Belichick running the ball, 40-something times, 10 for Harris, 24 for Stevenson, 4 for Bolden, Aguilar. Kendrick Bourne gets a run. Smith gets a run. Mac Jones ran the ball 5 times for -3. But they ran this ball. Mac Jones threw the ball 3 times. 3 times. Completed 2 for 19 yards. Could you imagine if Jalen Hurts threw the ball 3 times? What would be said? It'd be a laughing stock. But Mac Jones and Bill Belichick, they're smart. They're smart. They're geniuses. In that run where we started against the Lions running the ball, realizing we are stronger, bigger, faster up front, and we have a multitude of running backs, Jalen Hurts was a lead back in multiple games of that, and he threw the passes efficient, right? If you're only throwing 150 yards, people are like, he only threw the ball 200 yards, less than 200 yards. But if you complete 13 passes for 147 yards, you're still averaging 11 yards per completion. That's still a first down per completion. It's not no 7 yards, 6 yards. It's not dink and dunk. See, people throw the ball 300 times. People have 300 yards. Why? Because they throw the ball 42 times and completed 30 of them. 30 gets you 300. 13 gets you 150. It's still efficient throws that are past 10 yards. But he's just not doing it often because we have runs going past 10 yards, right? I just want to show that it's a GOAT coach doing even worse in the run game, and they're going to go to the playoffs. Now, let's get to this Eagles offense in totality, right? I again believe that in that 3-1 stretch, you saw the Lions, he threw the ball, he completed 14 passes. Then he completed 17. Then he completed 20. Then he threw the ball 20-something and only completed like 13 or 15. But at the end of the day, it was going up. And the passes, watch the games, pocket in the middle to Dallas Goedert, in the middle to Devontae Smith. Throw on time down the field to Quez Watkins, he dropped it, right? Throw on time to Devontae Smith, he goes up and mauls Patrick Surtain. You know, we saw him throw the passes that I said, okay, he's not doing it 30 times a game, but this is stuff that he didn't do against the Cowboys early, against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, against the San Francisco 49ers, the Carolina Panthers. Jalen Hurts has to be better in the pocket. I understand that. But while he's getting better in the pocket, he was offering us a winning formula with the run game. It's not flashy. It's not fancy. The Tennessee Titans went to the AFC Championship, but you didn't really want to watch their games. The San Francisco 49ers went to the Super Bowl, but you didn't want to watch their games. Rushing in the NFL, ranking Eagles number 1. Where do we rank in passing yards per game? 30th. Was a winning formula when we were doing it the bully way. Our offensive line is bigger than yours. We got multitude of people who can run it. But this is where it gets crazy, right? First in rushing, second to last in passing. But when you look at our total offense, you combine the rushing yards, you combine the passing yards, right? That's what gets you down the field. We're 13th. We're better than the middle of the pack in total offense. And if you look at the rankings, you know, from 13th to 8th or 7th is what, 10, 12 yards different, like 10 yards different? Now, let's look at points scored per game and where we rank in points scored per game, right? Because you can go up and down the field. If you're not getting points, if you're not getting field goals, if you're not getting touchdowns, I don't care how many times you go up the field. The Philadelphia Eagles ranked 10th in points per game. So the Eagles' defense got to be better because if you can score 10th, if you're 10th scoring points, our defense got to be better. And I know the first thing people are going to say is, well, we only scored 7 or points against the Giants. It was one of them totally letdown games, a trap game that became the trap game that some of us predicted would be a trap game. Vikings just felt a trap game. Welcome back to the playoff race, Eagles, because of the Vikings falling in the trap game. They beat the Packers, they beat the Chargers, but they can't beat the Lions. Oh yeah, I forgot, divisional opponent. What the people think about the Vikings, the Viking fans ain't changing their mind. They either liked Kirk Cousins or they didn't. They still like their receivers, they still like their offense. But you can look at that 30 in passing, but still remember that first. And the passing will get better as the running continues to do its dominance. And 13th in total offense and 10th in scoring. Listen, Washington football team is about to feel something. This Eagles team is underrated and it's underappreciated all across the board, right? We were only supposed to win 3 games. That's it. We passed 3 games. And we got 4 games left. I'm going to tell you what, the Philadelphia Eagles that were supposed to only win 3 games all season is going to win 3 games in the last 4. Hey, I'm not cocky. I'm confident. And until my team gets proven to be mathematically out, anything is possible. I believe in just the underdog mentality, not the dog mentality, the underdog mentality. With all that being said, let me know all your thoughts in the comment section about us being a run-heavy team, but sprinkling in with Jalen Hurts the right passes, right? Keep Jalen Hurts under center, away from the RPOs. He was throwing over the middle when that was happening. I saw it, and then it went away. Play smart football, protect the ball, run, efficient passing, get at the defense, right? Send the hounds. Let Darius Slay shadow whoever is number one. Leave all your thoughts in the comment section, Philly Nation, because I love hearing from you. Until next time, y'all know what time it is. We are out.